You have to say your first hymn, which will be 190. So let's pray. God our Father, you gave to Zechariah and Elizabeth in their old age a son called John. He grew up strong in spirit, prepared the people for the coming of the Lord, and baptized them in the Jordan to wash away their sins. Help us who have been baptized into Christ to be ready to welcome him into our hearts, and to grow strong in faith by the power of the Spirit. We ask this through Jesus Christ, the light who is coming into the world. Amen. It's time to confess our sins. Heavenly Father, you call us to prepare for the coming of your Son. Forgive us our unreadiness to receive him. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you proclaim by John the Baptist. Help us also prepare your way. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Holy Spirit, you speak through the prophets. Make us attentive to hear your word. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all things. And keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And spread the calling to the third Sunday. O Lord Jesus Christ, who at your first coming sent your messenger to prepare your way before you, grant that the ministers and stewards of your mysteries may likewise so prepare and make ready your way by turning the hearts of disobedient to the wisdom of the just. But at your second coming, to judge the world, you may be found an acceptable people in your sight, for you are alive and reign with you, with the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, with thanks in all circumstances, For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise the word, the words of prophets. But test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Who are you?
He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord,' as the prophet Isaiah said." Now they had been sent from Pharisees. They asked him, "Why then are you baptizing if you are neither the Messiah nor Elijah nor the prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize with water. Among you stands one you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." This took place in Bethany, across the Jordan, where John was baptized. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Because they do
were looking or waiting for the Messiah. They were waiting for the Messiah mentioned by the prophets in their scriptures. They were waiting for the Savior who would come and heal their sufferings. They were waiting for a Messiah who would free from them from this slavery and fought against the Romans. So when they asked this, but who is he? In return, John the Baptist answered them with a quotation from Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3. And while today I was doing my morning devotion from a mobile application, I came to know about that Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3 emphasizes the preparation for the Lord's arrival in the desert. Isaiah's prophecy spoke about the return of Jewish exiles from Babylonian to Jerusalem. John the Baptist applies this to himself, calling out in the dark in the desert to lead people to the Messiah, especially those facing spiritual dryness and sin-induced struggles. Paul addressed Williams regarding our today's gospel reading, wrote in the Canterbury Preacher Companion 2024 that the usual picture of John the Baptist is a loud, disruptive, and socially inappropriate preacher. Yet, in our gospel reading, John is anything but this. He is quietly respectful and says what he is not. Is not the Messiah, is not Elijah, is not the prophet. The point here is not why he refused to be all that. The question is, why did the Pharisees ask John this question? The NIV Quest Study Bible answers this question is that the Sanhedrin, the highest court of the Jews, was forced to investigate individuals suspected of being false prophets. They also wanted to evaluate claims that John fulfilled Old Testament prophecy. Malachi had predicted that Elijah would make an appearance before Messiah's coming, and Moses has predicted that a great prophet would one day arise. And that is why they came to John and question him. But John did not lose his focus and asked them to prepare yourself for what is coming. The kingdom of God is here. Prepare yourself for it. Preparation is important for everything. Just as we prepare ourselves for Christmas or anything, or any big event, we need to prepare ourselves for God. Just as we prepare our homes and the churches for Christmas, we need to prepare ourselves for the second and the final coming of Jesus. John the Baptist spent his whole life proclaiming for the coming kingdom of God, and during his life, he never tried to put himself in the center point. He always put Christ in the center instead of him. John has done what was given to him. He played his part in this play. He completed the work assigned to him. But God's eternal kingdom is yet to come. That is why the word of God tells us today, make your will stay, because the kingdom of heaven is near. John the Baptist preached what he had been doing. His task was preparing your heart hearts of the people for the coming of the Savior, and he fulfilled that task with a great grace. That is why Lord Jesus himself said in the gospel account that John was the greatest among all the people who came into this world. And now it is our responsibility to prepare not only ourselves but the people around us for the time when the Lord Jesus will return to this world to establish his eternal kingdom. And now when he comes, he will not come in an innocent and a harmless child, but as a mighty king. And will be partakers of his eternal kingdom to all who believe in him and call him God and Savior. During his advent, as he prepared to celebrate the birth of God in human flesh, let us also prepare ourselves for the time when we realize our personal, family, and congregational responsibility, and that is, we are to receive Jesus at his coming in his kingdom. And I pray that God will enable us to work for his kingdom in a such way that God will be pleased with us as he was with John, and that he may rejoice in his kingdom with all the saints, including John the Baptist. Amen.
Shelter or medical supplies. channels of your light, hope, and encouragement. May your kingdom come. Compassionate Father, we remember and pray for the sick, the suffering, the homeless, and the hungry, that we may always recognize the Christ who lives in them and share with them the gifts that God has given to us. This morning we pray especially for Helen Partington, Michael O'Connor, Ben Rose, Natalie Coleman, Dominic Abt, Carl Dodden, Catherine Herbert, Tony Parker, Pauline Baldinger, Pamela Aspen, and Anne Stewart. May your kingdom come. Loving Father, we commend to your love those who have died, loved ones with special needs at this time, whose memory we treasure. May they and we in our turn experience forever the joy of your eternity. This morning, we remember Alan Warren, Christopher Noel Gaffney, and Elsie Holt. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. May your kingdom come. Lord God, may we, your people, look forward to the birthday of Christ and experience the joy of salvation and celebrate Christmas with love and thanksgiving. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers.
Please stand if you're able for peace. In the tender mercy of our God, the blessing from on high shall rest upon us, to give life to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Bless for one another the sign of God.
Thank you.
draws from the native of love to make the facility of our praise a dwelling place of your glory.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed joy and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and Everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son. He is the one foretold by the prophets, whom the Virgin Mother bore with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist was his herald and made him known, and at last he came. In his love, Christ fills us with joy as we prepare to celebrate his birth, so that when he comes again, he may find us washing in prayer, our hearts filled with wonder and praise. And so with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise. In the same way after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory.
So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice at once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom, all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of St. Nicholas and all the saints, we praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O Lord, for these heavenly gifts. Kindle in us the fire of your Spirit, that when your Christ comes again, we may shine as lights before his face. He is alive and reigns, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. The time and living we declare your love. Give us grace and open the gates of glory. May we who share Christ's body live this risen life. Notices at the back of the few sheets, most of them, the one I've got from the North Text is the Christmas service at St. Nicholas Church. Today we are having our chalice service at 5 p.m. And then on the 4th, on Christmas Eve, we're going to be at 4 p.m. the Christmas and Crib service. And then on this Christmas Eve at 7:30, there will be a midnight mass. On Christmas Day at 10:30 a.m., the parish priest is here. So you all welcome to join these services. If for any reason you're not here, please do keep those services and all the events in your place as well.